Welcome to the Hanel Modus 600 RTE speedlight. In this video, I speak in some more detail about how to use the Viper TTL on-camera controller to manage your off-camera speedlights. If you purchased the wireless kit or the Pro kit, then you know that these ship with a Viper TTL unit. The Modus speedlights in the kit will already be matched to work with the Viper TTL controller. So you'll have a kit that looks something like this if you purchase the Pro kit, and they will work out of the box, as I say. If, however, you want to move on and maybe start to use some third-party speedlights, then you will need to do a little bit of digital channel matching. So in this kind of arrangement, the Viper TTL sits on the camera hot shoe. It's the master for the whole system. So this will be the one which will decide the channel matching arrangement. First, you must press the test button on the top and switch on the Viper TTL, and the display will show coding. You can leave the Viper TTL to one side for the moment. If you want to match in your Modus 600 RT, then press function button 2 and keep it pressed while you switch on the unit, and you'll see that the display will show slave OK. You can switch off that Modus. And now I'm just going to match in the second Modus in the same way. Hold in function button 2, switch it on, and I have slave OK on the display. So now both of my Modus are matched in to the Viper TTL. I can go ahead now and think about how I will merge in third-party speedlights. I've got two options here. I can use a Viper TTL receiver, and to match this in, again, I press the test button, switch on the unit, and release the button. And you'll see that we have a steady red light to indicate that the receiver is now matched to my TTL Viper unit. I can switch that off. Finally, we have the capture unit. To match that in, press the button once more, switch it on, and you'll see the light go to steady red almost immediately. Now the capture unit is matched in as well. I can power that down. Now that I've matched in both my Modus, my Viper TTL receiver, and my capture receiver, I can switch off the master unit because I've done all my coding at this stage. Viper TTL will sit on the camera shoe, power it up, and now it's ready to go to start controlling the speed lights. Third party speed light I can fit to the Viper TTL receiver. I can fit another third party speed light to the capture receiver. For the two Modus, I've already matched them in. I must just make sure now that they are set as slaves and that they're set as 2.4 GHz radio slaves. This button here will allow me to cycle through the various options. And what I want to arrive at is the radio icon is on to show I'm working on 2.4 GHz wireless, and I've got slave on. I can assign these now to different groups using the group button. So here I will assign this speed light to group A. Just repeat the process for the other Modus. I'm going to set this one to group B. So now I have group A, group B. My third party speed light I can assign to group C using the little slide switch on the side of the Viper unit here. So I've assigned that to group C. I've got A, B, and C, and my other third party speed light, which, because it's sitting on a capture unit, is actually outside group structure, and it will always fire when it's switched on. On the Viper TTL unit, I have three displays which allow me to decide the various modes that the groups will work on. I can switch them into manual mode, TTL mode, or I can switch them off. So as an example here, I'm going to switch off groups B and C and just fire group A. Now I'm going to switch off group A and just fire group B. Finally, I'll fire just group C on its own. Of course, I can, if I want to, fire all of them at the same time. And I can put them into different modes. I can have one in TTL mode, one in manual mode, and so forth. The speedlight which is sitting on the capture receiver, as I mentioned earlier briefly, is outside the group structure. This must be in manual mode, and it will always fire. So I've actually switched off the groups A, B, and C now. And we can see unit which is sitting on the capture has triggered. In another video, we'll show more detail about how to set up the different values and the different modes on the Viper TTL unit. You can check out that video for more details on how to do that. But for the moment, this is an introduction and it shows how you can use the Viper TTL on your camera to control off-camera speed lights, third-party flash guns using a Viper TTL receiver, third-party flash guns using a capture receiver. So check out some of the other videos in this series for more details of how to get the best from your Modus 600RT.